This baby boy would have turned 8 months old tomorrow. He won't because he died at daycare. His parents want to make sure no one forgets their child or what happened to him.
This is the worst, most horrible thing you can ever do is hold your son and he's gone.
The babysitter charged in their baby's death will go before a judge tomorrow. Good evening, I'm Brandi Petersen.
I'm Rob McCartney. 37-year-old Teresa Chapin charged with neglect of a dependent person and child endangerment. Arrested in Council Bluffs after the baby died in August.
Lane Thomas was a happy 5-month-old boy. Perfection, according to his dad. Nick and Alicia Thomas are sharing their story for one reason. To make sure what happened to their little boy doesn't happen to anyone else's baby.
It feels like just yesterday that we were holding him and playing with him.
Lane Thomas should be playing with his sisters, watching football with his dad, giggling for his mom.
He just smiled. He was just the happiest baby you could have asked for.
August 17th, the whole family took oldest daughter Mackenzie to her first day of school. Then Lane went to daycare. That was the last time Alicia and Nick Thomas saw their son alive.
I can't read the reports because I don't know if I can handle it, because sometimes the unknown is almost better.
Alicia had to know, and what happened, she says, was like a bad dream.
You're not supposed to lay him on an adult bed. He was on his stomach and with blankets around him.
Lane's babysitter found him unresponsive an hour and a half later.
We got to see him, and we had to let him go.
Most horrible thing you can ever do is hold your son and he's gone.
The official cause of death, sudden unexplained infant death. Lane's babysitter, Teresa Chapin, is charged with 2 felonies, including neglect.
I should have asked more questions. I shouldn't have assumed. I should have, but my girls were happy and he was happy and, it seemed okay.
3 months later, Lane's bedroom, just as it was the last time he slept here. Even his clothes, untouched.
Those are ones that smell like him. Like, those can't be washed, those can't be touched. And
Nick had Lane's face tattooed on his arm.
So I can look down and remember the smile that my son had and how beautiful it was.
They're trying to stay strong for their daughters.
It's hard, but I'm happy and I'm blessed that I was able to have him for that 5 months and be able to cherish every moment that I've had with him.
The Thomas's advice to parents, follow the guidelines from doctors and hospitals. Always lay your baby on his or her back and don't put anything else in the crib with them. We've posted more resources on our website, KETV.com. And there's also a fundraiser this Saturday, a benefit concert at Chrome Lounge at 85th and Park. All proceeds will go to the Lane Thomas Memorial Fund. You can also donate at any U.S. bank.